シーダコンタクトレンズ。
So, a little about me. My name is Hamza Sheikh. I am an optometrist having 10 years of experience in different fields like store optom and optom training. So, I am currently working with Seed Contact Lens in India as a professional service. So, the today content will be the EDOF, the science behind it. Then we go to a design of EDOF, then the fitting procedure which is involved in EDOF. Clinical question result of comparison of various type of multifocal. We are going to compare various type of multifocal design with EDOF. Also, how EDOF can be used for myopia control. Also, some study which are going to take care for the EDOF in myopia control. So, first of all, you know, if you want to start with a study of multifocal design, you have to get an image of how a multifocal contact lens is made. So, for you know, taking a care of the image and the design of multifocal, we need a machine which is called as a contact lens optical quality analyzer, CLOQA. This machine will let us know the different curve and different power which are there in a multifocal lenses. So, if you just need to summarize how multifocal lenses evolve in over of this year, let's see, in 1990 we get a differentiated pattern design which is a concentric pattern. Then we evolve to a two zone design which is center near and center distance. And now in mid of 2000 we are somewhere between a progressive design and a blended multifocal design which is, you know, two type plus and transition zone. But now also people, you know, do carry a thing that multifocal lenses is not working so well as far as their near and intermediate zone is working. So in 2010 we started with a progressive design, but most of them was a center near only. Then in later half it become a center distance for progressive also. But what's next? So now we are thinking, like, you know, multifocal design nowadays should have to evolve in a such a way that, you know, patient can see a better vision in a normal working environment. So let's get started with EDOF, the science behind it. So EDOF, the extended depth of focus, it is actually a visible range of human ocular system by extending the depth of focus. So a system which, you know, extend your depth of focus by enhancing the different aberration of your higher order aberration things. So EDOF is not a new thing in the market right now. As you can see, EDOF is previously in I hope every can So EDOF is not a new design, as I told earlier. It has been incorporated in various IOL technology, but not in recent, which has been involved in a contact lens. So EDOF is currently available in various IOL, which is intraocular lenses, and they take care of EDOF by, you know, letting the IOL be in a low addition power or a spherical diffractive design or a spherical aberration control or pinhole. Pinhole work very well when you want to, you know, take care into consideration of your extended depth of focus or a depth of focus, because, you know, pinhole actually just block the peripheral deviating ray and just allow your, you know, concentrated ray on your retina. So pinhole is a very good method, but as far as your peripheral vision is concerned, pinhole will not give you that much of vision, but it has been taken care in IOL technology from many years. So some of the options are mentioned below, like the Tinus Symphony from Johnson & Johnson and AcuFocus AC8. So these are all IOL lenses which has EDOF technology inbuilt in it, but not now many lenses, or not now any lenses of contact lenses which has EDOF technology. So recently many people have started with different technology of getting control with extended depth of focus, but seed EDOF is the only lenses which involve EDOF technology in our current contact lens design. So let's start with how a lens work. So you can see an image over here where a spherical lens ray coming from an infinity form a point focus. So let's say that point focus is an image where you can see all the vision very clearly. So in later slide, I will be using this point focus thing very well. So just understood that this point focus, I can just show you. Okay, so this point focus is actually a ray which get coincide with your retina and give you a better visual quality. In next term, this focus only will give you a clearer image at your retina, but when you go beyond and below of this point image, your image quality get degraded at very high level. So you can see in this slide, when an image is focused on your retina, the image at a particular point focus will give you a good quality of image, as you can see a graph over here. But as we go beyond or below of that particular distance, the graph fall drastically, giving you a blur image, which is not required when you are talking about in multifocal contact lenses. So here EDOF, we are trying to not get this graph down so drastically, so that this can continue over a span of time and give you a better image quality at a particular distance also, at a particular level also. So the range which human eye can see around the focus is, if you are seeing near object at an distance of 33 centimeter from an 3 diopter lenses, so this is the focus image which you will be seeing. And human eye has an inbuilt depth of focus which is around 2 to 3 centimeters, you can say around 0.25 diopter, which you can see. But even when you shift your focus from that point focus thing, your image get drastically blurred. And if you go beyond 3 to 4 centimeter, again, the image is not able to see clearly. So right now, what we are trying to do is, get your image into focus and give you an extended range where you can see your image clearly. So as you can see over here, this is a depth of focus of a normal human eye when they are seeing near, and the below one is what we are trying to do through a technology which is called as an extended depth of focus, which will give you a more range, a more flexible range for your near vision. So as we all know, as I have mentioned earlier, that a pinhole technique will actually give you a better depth of focus when we are talking about a near vision or as well as a distance vision, because pinhole actually block the peripheral deviating ray, which will form the image on your retina with getting blur, and only allow a concentrated rays on your retina which gets clear. So as we go from normal pupil size to a small pupil size, our depth of focus actually get increased. So that is why many of the IL lenses are coming with a pinhole type of vision, which will give you a good depth of field or depth of vision. So how to extend depth of focus? In current IL industry, extended depth of focus can be achieved by a low addition or a spherical diffractive design or a spherical aberration control method or a pinhole. There are special methods where we can actually control the spherical aberration to give you a extended depth of focus. For a contact lens, there is still no product declared themselves as EDOF design currently. So if you talk about a bifocal contact lenses or bifocal spectacle lenses, this lenses will give you a two focus, which is also a point focus. One will be for your near and one will be for your distance. Again, in this point focus, you will get a clear image at that point, and the image will drastically drop back when you are moving beyond or behind of this focus point. So in between of this image is actually your addition power, where image is not so clear, and if you are talking about an intermediate zone. Now let's talk about the lens design which EDOF currently is having. So EDOF is currently get incorporated with a seed material which we call as an SIB, seed ionic bond, or a Zwitter ionic material. It's a one of its kind material get designed from a Japan company. It's having a higher oxygen permeability around 42.9. It's the first material which you can see is a bi-ionic material, which will give you a comfortness of ionicity and also a deposit resistance of a non-ionic material. So being a high water content molecule or being a high water content contact lenses also, this bioionicity will hold your contact lens water molecule very tightly. Thus the per evaporation rate is very slow. So all in this thing, the EDOF technology combined with a seed SIV material give you a better choice of option over the contact lenses for press bio. So let me take you to the person who have actually developed this technology. The person name is Brannon Holden. He was from Sydney, Australia. Unfortunately, he left us in 2015 July, and he was working with a technology called as EDOF. Now, you know, seed is taking care for the manufacturing department of EDOF, taking care with their contact lens material. But the person behind the development of seed was from BHVI, which is Brannon Holden Vision Institute. Obviously, the name was given to this institute after 2010 due to Sir work, all he has done. He was a professor, he was a doctorate, he was PhD in different level, he was PhD in science and all things. So he was a huge person in our industry, but again, he left us in 2015, giving us a more opportunity to use a design of EDOF. So what he know that shortcoming of current multifocal was, first of all, variability in visual performance at various distance. As we know that contact lenses have different visual performance. When we talk about bifocal, it gives you a good visual performance for your distance near. But when we are talking about a multifocal contact lenses, they will give you a good visual performance for your distance near as well as your intermediate zone. Again, where your all image will be clear at particular distance, not at all level beyond and below of that point focus. Again, effect of changing pupil. As we all know, in a progressive multifocal lenses, your centration is very much important, as well as your pupil size is very much important. If a person is having a very constricted pupil, many of the design will not work with your multifocal contact lenses. As we go with the movement of decentration of your lenses, if your contact lens is not well centered, again, the optics of your contact lens will not match with your eye and will not give you a good quality of vision. So challenge is to create a multifocal that provides special stable visual performance under a broad range of visual condition. So what Sir Brannon Holden has worked for is to create a multifocal which will take care of all of this thing and give you a better visual performance in all area. So we develop a EDOF by the name of Seed One Day Pure Extended Depth of Focus. It's actually a collaboration between BHVI and Seed. EDOF lens minimize variability in visual performance at varying distance, overcoming the limitation of current multifocal contact lenses. So EDOF also provide a good perceived image quality under broad range of spectrum. So combining these two technology give you a multifocal lens where we can actually unlock the many possibilities of multifocal optics. So this is the diagrammatic representation of how EDOF lenses are. We have actually three add power, which is 0.75, 1.5 and 2.25. So you can see it's a very unique design. It's neither your concentric ring bifocal nor your progressive lens. It's actually made by using a higher order aberration control value. So they take care each and every rays coming from infinity or coming from an object and bend them to form a line image, not a point image or a point focus. Let me introduce you that thing. So how does an EDOF actually work? So this is a diagrammatic representation of a single vision contact lenses. So the light coming from infinity get bent toward a principal focus because of the change in the refractive index and give you a point focus. So as you can see a graph over here, the image quality goes very high when we are seeing at a point focus and drop drastically when we are moving below or ahead of this line in a principal axis. So what EDOF is trying to do is to make this graph not get fall in a image quality, but continue in that image quality and then fall at a particular distance. So you get a line focus, not a point focus. So the range of human eye can see around is around, from 2 to 3 centimeter around the depth of focus from your point focus. So now EDOF has a technology by which they can control the higher order aberration and manipulate each and every ray coming from an object or an infinity to give you a line focus. As you can see a difference between these normal lenses and an EDOF lenses, here you can see EDOF is actually making a line focus, then in point focus. So this line will give you a higher visual quality, also continue your visual performance even at a particular distance also. So not giving you a point focus for that. So this is the thing which we make behind the scenes for EDOF lenses. So let me tell you about one thing which we are going to study in a high in you know further slide for the research and things. If you are doing a research of any multifocal contact lenses or any lenses, you need to know about the retinal image quality. So we all know that human eye have an some amount of spherical aberration. It gives you a spherical aberration at a particular distance due to your accommodation also. So a study performed by Larry Henn, Sir Arthur Bradley, Jin Hong, and Raymond, who give us the idea of how an retinal image quality is performed. So let us see a graph first over here. This is the contact lens being tested. Like a normal contact lens will give you a graph like this from a modulus. OTF is actually ocular transfer per function from one point to a 0 point. So a contact lens higher image quality will be around 1 point. So this is a normal special frequency, a contact lens, how a contact lens will perform on a normal eye. And when we combine these two graphs, we get a graph of this. So this is actually a graph how a contact lens is performing on an eye. So if we want a contact lens to be, you know, perfect at all distance and all in quality, we need a point from 1 to 0.6. Okay, so if we need a contact lens to be at a clearer part, we need a contact lens to fall between 1 and 0.6. And combining it with a contact lens on an eye, the actual performance, we get a graph like this. So how retinal image quality will be formed is actually by dividing your actual contact lens with an ideal contact lens property. So in short, if you want a image to be clearer in all part, we need a graph or we need a image to be formed between 1 point to 0.6. So let's talk about an study which has been done by Ravi C. Bakaraju, Klaus Ehrman, and Arthur H. Arthur, which is an head of department in BHVI in Australia, Sydney. So they have done a study on different type of multifocal where they have considered different things like pupil diameter, the change in pupil diameter on different contact lenses, the ocular aberration on different contact lenses, and lens decentration. And they have taken a contact lens which is which was from different brand also, which is AQV OSS for presbyopia, Air Optics Aqua Multifocal, and EDOF. So AQV OSS is actually a type of bifocal which give you a concentric ring type of thing. Then AQV Air Optics Multifocal is actually a progressive type of multifocal design which will give you a progression view from distance to near. And we have our new technology EDOF. EDOF is actually a non-monotonic aperiodic. So you cannot judge the design of EDOF, which is, you know, either it's in a progressive one or it's in a bifocal with an intermediate zone. So EDOF is itself a different. So you cannot judge EDOF whether it's a center near or center distance or a progressive type. So here you can see a graph. Let me explain you about this. The first of all, we will take care into consideration of pupil size on different contact lenses. So as you can see, the first line, the all three graph is from AQV OSS and Air Optics, and the last one is from the EDOF. So this line, you can see a different pupil performance from 3 mm to 5 mm, and we go from one line, which is the low head, the mid head, and the high head. So in a bifocal contact lenses, you can see a graph working very well with the pupil size in all three head, while in a progressive one, in the second line, you can see when pupil size is considered, the graph is not going in a very tight situation. It goes haywire. Also in a mid head, you can see it getting crossed over. So what we need a graph to be, you know, constant and have a very tight relationship between all of the pupil size. So in this, the Air Optics multifocal is actually not working very well. But the EDOF, you can see a tight relationship than both of them. So pupil size, when we take consider the progression, multifocal design doesn't work very well. So when we take with the decentration, as we all know, the decentration part in progressive lenses is very much critical. The progressive lens has to be get centered well to work with the contact lens design. So when a lens get decentered, you can see air optics multifocal getting very much higher distortion in their image quality, but EDOF showing you a very tight relationship with all of the decentered one. You can see the last three graph for the EDOF. So the another one is ocular aberration. Again, if a contact lens is does not get involved with an ocular aberration and doesn't go through it, the contact lens is not working very well. So in ocular aberration also, you can see EDOF giving you a very tight relationship over all the module of the eye. Let me tell you, this all studies were done on a module eye, not on an actual eye. It was done with a module eye to see whether the lens is performing well or not. And what we came up with this, that seed EDOF is working very well when we know the changing size of the pupil is matter, where the visual performance with the lens decentered. So even your pupil size and decentered will not hamper your vision as far as EDOF is concerned. So these are the different design. As I said earlier, EDOF cannot be classified at center distance or center near because it's overall unique design where they have taken a different curve for your lens. Each and every ray get hit to a principal axis for forming a line focus. This is a typical example of how a lens will work. Many ophthalmic lenses work for this example, comparing with single vision, bifocal and progressive. So somehow EDOF will give you a same vision how and progressive ophthalmic lens give you, where your near, your intermediate, your extended vision is clear. Also, if you are doing any focus thing, like if your image is focused at a particular distance, EDOF give you a flexible range to see beyond and below of that image, even if it's a clear for that thing. So the extended range which human eye can see around the focal point with EDOF technology is actually been enhanced from 3 centimeter to 5 to 7 centimeters beyond and below, which is around 0.5 diopter than your corrected value. So it's a very good image and very good table over here. As you can see, we have compared three type of multifocal. The first one is the bifocal, the second is the progressive multifocal, and the third one is EDOF. So you can see a different type of design. The bifocal will have a particular area for your near and distance. The progressive will have a particular area from your near, then it goes beyond to from the intermediate zone to their distance zone. Where EDOF, you can see it's a unique design where you cannot follow the lens design pattern. So if we take care of a pupil size, a pupil which is very much constricted will give you a limited area in your bifocal contact lenses and also in your progressive multifocal lenses. So let's see if you're wearing a center near multifocal type of progressive lenses, and if you are moving outside in a very sunny light or in a day environment, your pupil get constricted and more of the area which you are seeing it will be from your distance zone. But when you are seeing it through an EDOF, even if your pupil get constricted from 2 to 3 mm also, it provide you a greater range of flexibility from your distance vision to your near vision. Also, when your pupil get dilate again in an contact lenses, like bifocal will give you a better vision for your distance either for near, but EDOF will give you a extended range of focus from that point of view. The main advantage of EDOF is when your lens is not stable, like when your lens get decentered, even the bifocal lenses or progressive lenses will not work very well, because the optics of your contact lenses has to get involved with your eye optics. But EDOF give you that range where even the decentration will not hamper your image quality at a greater extent, because the EDOF make a form of line focus which give you a flexible range where your principal axis or the point focus can form on your retina. Okay, so extended depth of focus, there are lenses which provide a good perceived image quality at all distance throughout the range of depth of focus. Through EDOF design, which can provide presbyopia patient continue the stable quality of vision, significantly defend the effect of pupil sizes change. vision stable with lens decentration. So this is how an EDOF lenses is formed. Three lenses designed from low, mid, and high end. The C-EDOF cannot be classified as I have said earlier. It is neither center distance, neither center near. So as you can see, when we go beyond and below of the higher or low ed, so when the ed is very high, as we have taken ed which is more than 2 or 2.25, the depth of focus area will be very much. So if you go to a lower ed, the depth of focus area will be less, because you know, if you are going to a higher ed capability, it gives you a flexible range of playing with the power of your lenses. But when we are going with the higher ed, take into consideration that perceived image quality will depreciate. So that is why in every multifocal you know, company, they are saying that when you getting fit with a multifocal contact lens test, get stick to the low ed as low ed as much as possible, because low ed will give you a higher perceived image quality than a higher ed. Don't go with the you know, addition power of your patient or your patient prescription power. Try with the lower ed, see how patient is performing with that low ed thing, and see if patient can continue with that thing. So the perceived image quality for your patient will be very much satisfactory. So let me introduce a person from Sydney. Name is Oliver Wu.
Hey, so Dr. Oliver Wu here.
Hello.
Dr. Oliver Wu from Sydney, Australia. He's one of the very experienced fitters in Australia, and I'm very privileged to have him to share a little bit about his experience with the EDOF lens. So, Dr. Wu, how long have you used the C-EDOF lens for?
Oh, probably about 5 or 6 months since the beginning of this year. Yeah, the really, really good lenses. Yeah, good to have extra option lenses in my practice for my patient needs, in visual needs.
Oh, excellent. Okay. So, how have you found the lens in terms of comfort and vision so far?
So far, the comfort, the vision, I would say probably 80-90% of them are really happy with the comfort, with the visions. Depends on what I use it for, okay? Probably we know EDOF lenses can have lots of different options in fitting the visual needs or some special requirements that we can use it for. Yeah.
Okay, so which patients are the ones that you fit the EDOF lens for at the moment?
Currently, I'm fitting like a presbyopic, like EDO we know is more for presbyopia, and also I use it for my myopia management use for the kids. But I have to make sure we know this lens that I use it as an off-label usage for the myopia management.
Yep. Yeah. Okay. Yep. And what about the success rate? How are you finding that for your presbyopia and myopia management?
For the presbyopia, we're really happy. Seriously, we're happy with the success, right? Like I said to a lot of my friends, make sure you follow the fitting guy. So if you follow the fitting guy, the success rate is pretty high. I would say for the presbyopia, probably close about 70-80%.
Okay.
The success rate is quite good and people are quite happy. And need a bit more chair time to fine tune a bit of the like the extra 0.25, a little bit high, and I mean mid, low, a little bit of chair time. Probably I would say sometime you might need about 2 to 3 visits to get them really, really right. I think really similar to other multifocal soft contact lenses, you need about 2-3 visits to make sure. And for the myopia management, I'm pretty comfortable to use it as another option for my myopia management option for the kids. And so far, all the kids are really happy and with the vision, with the comfort. And I would only can say it's still a bit too early to say whether it's really, really superior than the other options, because I only use it for about 4 or 5 months. And we still need a lot of data, a lot of clinical numbers to tell how good the EDOF lenses, like the C-EDOF lenses in the myopia management bracket. Off-label use, okay? Make sure you know what I'm talking about, off-label use there.
But it's so far so good.
So far so good, I'm really happy with this, yeah.
Okay. So would you say that the EDOF lens is a valuable addition to your practice?
Yeah, I think not just to my practice. I think it will be a really good, valuable option for everyone can have access to this, to their practice in both presbyopic side and myopia management side. And also really good lens that you can add value to your practice and also build your practice from a different category.
Okay. Yeah. Well, anything else you want to add?
I think be more adventurous and open your arms to try different things, okay? And you will see a more different world when you open your hands, open your arms to try different things.
Good. Excellent. Well, okay. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. No problem. Okay.
So let's move ahead with the fitting procedure of EDOF guide. You know, you have seen how EDOF lenses are different from multifocal contact lenses right now in the market and how it perform well with other contact lenses. Sorry. Okay. So, fitting guide is very crucial part when you are talking into consideration of a specialty contact lenses. So, I consider EDOF and all press by IP contact lenses as in specialty contact lenses. It not the lenses which actually let you work on an overview basis, like, you know, taking care of your patient prescription and giving contact lenses on their prescription only. When a progressive lens or a multifocal lens is involved, you actually need to have a chair time for working very well with your vision of your patient. So as far as it goes with EDOF lenses also. So as far as the fitting guide is concerned, the first is your patient selection. So, you know, many times when you are selecting your patient, we are doing very much mistake in selecting patient where the patient is having very high expectation with all the visual demand and coming up with hearing all the things like multifocal lenses work very well with, over the expectation of their vision. So patient selection is very much important when we go with the multifocal contact lens fitting guide. So ideal presbyopic candidate of seed one day pure will be a patient with a refractive error of cylindrical power less than one diopter. Or let us say if a patient is having refractive power which is 3:1, the three part of your spherical component and one part of your cylindrical component, so you can actually convert this 3:1 ratio to your spherical equivalent, you can go ahead with the EDOF design. So 3:1 is the minimum ratio which we want. You can go higher, like 4:1 and 5:1, which will work even better. But below 3:1, like if it's 2:1, then your spherical equivalent will not work very well with your multifocal contact lens design, as goes with your single vision power also. So presbyope who might not achieve successful contact lens wearer is actually a critical or very fine visual demand at both distance and near. So if a person or if your patient is having a very much high demand for your distance and near, so it's not so a good go with the multifocal contact lens design, as we can see some patient working very fine, like printing, writing work, or doing some other fine tune work like the diamond merchant. So we don't prescribe multifocal contact lens for them because we actually need a higher magnification than your contact lens which can actually provide it to you. Monocular distance visual acuity poorer than 6:12 with spherical equivalent refractive correction. So if a person is having a poor visual acuity which is less than 6:12 or 6:12, it might not go well with the multifocal lens design. But let me say you, if a person is actually opting for using a multifocal lens design, they can actually go with EDOF lenses or any other multifocal. Just you need to have a consult with them. A pupil size which is less than 2.5 mm or a mesopic condition, abnormal binocular sensory function like your both eye not working very well, or if you're having any deviation in your eye in expectation of replacing spectacles. So contact lens is actually a very good choice when you're taking into consideration for having you a freedom from your spectacle. But at some point of view, you need your spectacle also when you're working day and night for lens expectation view. So spectacle replacement is not a contact lens, but also it gives you a support for your vision quality for your working life. So first of all, go with the initial lens selection, determine the correct lens power. So need to perform a visual acuity prescription and just determine the correct lens power for your EDOF lenses. Perform refraction, calculate the spherical equivalent, and determine the contact lens prescription after vortex distance calculation. Just overview of your vortex distance calculation. Many people are confused between vortex distance calculation to take care into consideration from 12 mm to 14 mm. But as far as contact lens is concerned, it will be very good if you actually can calculate the vertex distance from your spectacle, your patient's spectacle distance. Okay. The second step is determine the near addition. With patient wearing a distance full correction, determine the near addition based on patient reading needs. So do not give your patient your actual, the reading guide which we have in our clinic to consider if a patient can see N6 or not. Just give them a visual habit where they are, more comfortable with their day-to-day life, like their smartphone, like their magazine or tablet. Just don't go straight away to their to your reading guide which you have in your clinic. Give them their smartphone. Let's see if they can see from a lower addition power to the smartphone if they are comfortable. And if they need higher ed, go with the higher ed lenses, but don't give excess reading things like, your reading guide in your clinic which you have. Determine the dominant eye. As we all know, there are various methods to determine the dominant eye. As far as the multifocal contact lens is concerned, your eye actually work differently for your dominant and non-dominant. Like your dominant eye work very well for your distance, and you can go with the non-dominant eye for your near much powerful. But many of the time patient take care of their both eye binocularly. So if you want to know how you can actually determine the dominant eye, there are various methods. There are fog method, there are two diopter test trial method, there are triangle methods. So if you want to know about that, then you can actually search Google. You can just mail me. I can let you know about the determining the dominant eye. But don't get confused with different technique where you get confused between which eye is dominant. So if you want to start with a multifocal contact lens practice, you have to need to know about the basic of this prescribing thing. Choose the appropriate lens based on the RX determined above. Choose the appropriate lens design and insert the lens. You have to actually pre-calculate how your lens will work on your patient eye. Just not to insert the lenses and see how your eye is working. Pre-calculate how your lens will work, and you can actually come in front of you like how the lens will work when you are inserting the contact lens in your patient eye. Step five, it's a most crucial step when you are performing in any specialty contact lens, is allow 10 minutes for your lens to get settled. Don't get rushed when you're prescribing a multifocal contact lenses. Like you're just putting your multifocal contact lenses in your patient eye, giving them a rest of 2 to 3 minutes, and making them to view their near chart or view their mobile. Every contact lens, when they cover your eye, they settle on your cornea, they require some time to well settle on your cornea with getting used to with the tear film, the curvature of your cornea, as it's a soft contact lens. Give them some time, like 10 to 15 minutes. Let them experience how their vision is. Don't let them use their object in this particular time, like 10 to 15 minutes. Let them rest, let them see for distance, and after this thing you can go ahead with your distance calculation, not for your near calculation. So when you are fitting on multifocal contact lenses, go first with your distance calculation, because if your distance is not clear, you cannot clear your near vision accordingly. The step six is confirm the distance and near. So assess binocular vision and monocular vision. As we all know, there are two types of vision correction we can do, which is binocular and monocular vision correction. So if you don't know, let me know if you want to know about binocular vision correction or binocular stability. How we can do is actually stabilizing both of your eye accommodation function simultaneously. What we do in our clinic is actually we are doing a monocular refraction, where we close one eye, we make our patient to read from other eye, and one eye get close and their accommodation is at different level from other eye. But when you have performed your refraction, we have to do a binocular vision, which is binocular stability of both the eye. To improve distance visual acuity, add minus 0.5 to dominant eye or both eye. So again, there is a different calculation when we want to increase the vision for distance and near. Like if you want to increase your near vision, you have to add plus 0.25 step. So you can go ahead with adding plus 0.25 step in both eye or the non-dominant eye for checking for their near vision correction. And when we are going for the distance vision, you can actually add minus 0.25 for your distance vision correction as far as your myopia is concerned. But again, if it's a hyperopia, go with the more plus minus. So consider this as a rule. When you are fitting a multifocal contact lenses, more hyperop or more plus power is better to go with the near vision, and more myope is the better to go with the distance vision. So determining dominant eye using an alternate blur method. So let me introduce you one method where you can actually determine which eye is dominant. It's very simple. When you have done with your spherical refraction or spherocylindrical refraction, just open both eye, don't use the blocker, and use 1.50 diopter lenses and cover alternately between both eye. Okay, let patient your customer or your patient get focused on the visual acuity, the best corrected visual acuity. Let's say if it's a 6-6 line chart in a Snellen chart, so alternately cover 1.5 diopter to the both eye and make patient say that when I am putting this 1.5 diopter in each eye, in which particular way you or in which particular eye you feel more uncomfortable. So if the patient is saying when I am putting 1.5 diopter in my right eye and I am feeling more blur or more uncomfortable, then your right eye is actually a dominant eye, where your dominant eye has been suppressed and patient is not feeling very well, or his or her vision is getting disturbed. So this is the alternate blur method. Again, there are different methods. There are pencil pull method. There are, hand pull method, the triangle method. So if you want to know, let me know by mail or contact me. I can show you all this thing. So this is a particular table where we can see a procedure pattern for determining the addition power. So we have three add power in EDOF, which is low, mid, and high. So when we go from 0.75 diopter to 1.25 diopter, we actually use low add in both the eye. Okay, so your dominant eye, non-dominant eye work with the low add if your addition power is plus 1.25 diopter. And when we go beyond 1.25 diopter, is from 1.5 to 1.75 diopter, we are using mid add in both the eye. Just take into consideration, we are using same ad in both eye. We are not actually differentiating between non-dominant and dominant eye. But when we are moving ahead of plus 0.25, plus 0.2 diopter, we have to consider the dominant and non-dominant eye, because as we move ahead in the addition power, our image quality will get deteriorated, or your patient distance vision will get blurred. So the first rule for your multifocal successful fitting is to stick with the low head. So start with the low head, then go with the mid head. And if patient is not, stable or not very much satisfied with the vision for near, you can actually go with the mid and high head. Don't straight away jump with the higher head, because, your patient will not be so much comfortable with the higher addition power in your both eye. So again, one more thing I left. Don't use phoropter when you are prescribing a multifocal contact lenses, and when you are doing trial of that thing. Phoropter does not work well with your near, because when you are using phoropter, you are actually not making yourself in a comfortable position when you are reading. So use your trial frame instead, and choose more positive power for more plus lenses. As I said, more the plus power, more the near vision will get clear. Okay. So check the lens fitting. So when you have done with the fitting of the lenses and the prescription of the lenses, you can go ahead with the lens which shows a good fit. Lens has to be centered, sufficient lens movement. A lens movement is very crucial for the comfortability of your contact lens in the patient eye. If lens is not at all moving, then your patient will complain about the dryness or some foreign body sensation in the patient eye. See if you can get a lens movement from 1 mm to 2 mm of the lens movement when on blinking, or you can just have a push-up method. Good comfort from patient, satisfactory view, satisfactory distance and near vision, and you can actually dispense the lenses. So let's move ahead with some test and trial for a multifocal of this, which we have done. So this was a study which was done with contact lenses of EDOF, Air Optics Aqua Multifocal and Acuvi OSS. What they have done, they have taken a 43 presbyope patient from age of 42 to 63, and they have done a study of how a lens will perform in terms of visual quality and in terms of wearing hour and other questionnaire which they have taken. So if you can see over here, the three lenses, which is all three are presbyopic lenses, in terms of stereopsis, the EDOF lens perform very well when you can compare it with AOMP and AOP, the Air Optics and Air Optics Aqua. So here you can see a graph which is actually reverse. The lower the better performance. If I can show you this. Okay, so EDOF is performing very well when we are checking this stereopsis at 40 centimeter point of view. And when we are seeing about the clarity of vision, all three lenses perform almost the same for the distance. However, EDOF is performing better as far as Air Optics is concerned. But for near, EDOF is performing way higher than the actual multifocal lenses of both these two. So we can take into consideration that EDOF is giving you a better depth, a better visibility range for your near work and also for your intermediate zone. So it will not hamper your distance vision, but also give you a better flexible range for your near and intermediate zone when you compare with the bifocal and multifocal contact lens design in the market. So lack of ghosting, as we all know, when we are talking about a multifocal contact lenses, people do complain about ghosting when they are seeing for distance. Okay, so the ghosting image comes from a different area of contact lenses. Like if when you are seeing a distance image, the ghost image from a near visual area of contact lenses. So as you can see over here, the EDOF is performing well with the near zone and intermediate zone and also in distance zone. So this higher order aberration control method give you a better visual performance where you will not feel a ghosting of image at a particular distance. So overall vision satisfaction, EDOF get a very high score when you compare with the Air Optics and Acuvue OSS for a presbyope. So better in a visual performance, better in ghosting, like it gives you a less ghosting and visual comfort. So it worked very well over here. So as far as the wearing time is concerned, you can see we have compared two lenses, EDOF and Acuvue Moist Multifocal. So patient who have wear this lenses was actually, on an average of 10.8 or 10.6 hours, so 10 plus hours they have wear these lenses, and they have quoted that EDOF was a little bit more wearable than in terms of Acuvue Moist Multifocal. So both are of same material, like the same base. They both are hydrogel, but EDOF, when you combine with a seed ionic bond or a Zwitter ionic material, give you a higher flexible range in a wearing time, where patient actually can wear these lenses for a higher time than other multifocal lenses concerned. These are three lens design you can see, the Acuvue Moist, Air Optics and EDOF. So Moist is actually a bifocal type of design. You can see a representation of that, where Air Optics is a presbyopic type of design and EDOF it's on a different level of design where you can't judge whether it's a progressive one or a bifocal one, because each and every area of that lenses is modified to give you a line focus image. So these are the quality comparison for in-house lenses with seed. So in a presbyopic lenses, we have EDOF, which is extended depth of focus. Then we have seed one day pure flex. It's actually a pre-presbyopic lenses, which is considered to be people who are facing a presbyopic condition before the age of 40. So it's like an anti-fatigue lenses also, where your patient or the people who are working very far for the near vision, or they are not coping up with the near vision when they are doing a very lengthy near work. So you can go with the seed one day pure flex. And we have our original seed multifocal, which is a center distance multifocal with add power of 0.75 and 1.5, which is type A and B. So you can see a graph over here and a line in between, which will give you a higher quality of distance and near performance, where EDOF fall in between with the mid and high ad and low ad in that line only. So EDOF give you a better near and distance vision when we compare the in-house comparison also, because it's a different level of design, not being seen over this year. So it's been developed from BHVI, which is Brian and Holden Institute, and incorporated with seed contact lens design. So we are done with the EDOF's design, how we can actually fit EDOF lenses, and also some comparison of lenses with other multifocal contact lens in the market. So we are going with the myopia control thing, which we can do with seed EDOF also. So if you have any question, you can just actually ask me directly. Just unmute your mic, and if you have any doubt in this thing, you can ask.
Hi, good afternoon. I'm Preeta. I'm from Chennai. I represent Vasan. So my questions are, what is the base curve of this contact lens? And the second question would be, who would be more comfortable with, CDDOF, whether a emmetropic presbyope or a myopic or a hyperopic? Who would be the ideal patient to begin with?
Okay. So hello, Preeta. I will be sharing you the detail of seed, the power, the base curve, and all in the end of this slide. And your next question, who will be the person will be more comfortable when using EDOF? Look, nowadays we have contact lenses which are typical bifocal or progressive lens of design. So you will agree with me, if you are doing a multifocal or bifocal contact lens fit, you actually need to give a chair time to your patient or your customer when they are coming for the first fit or first trial of the multifocal contact lenses. So anyhow, your patient get adjusted for your distance and your near, but they somehow feel that they have to adjust your contact lenses for near or distance. Like if they can move their hand far beyond or far near to their face or their reading area, you can see they actually get they have to adjust the lenses for reading and distance. What is this? Because the traditional bifocal or multifocal or the progressive lenses give you a particular focus at a particular area. Like if you have taken a progressive lens, they will give you three focus, which is distance, near, and intermediate thing. What right now we have done with EDOF technology is we have not given you a point focus. Actually, we have given you a line focus. Like if you are concentrating at your near vision, you don't have to actually play with the power of your contact lenses in a progressive design. Like if I say I need a +3 diopter at 40 centimeter to read. So if I need a progressive lenses, I have to reduce or increase my power in able to see my object clear at a particular distance where I'm taking it near or where I'm taking it far away. So EDOF doesn't incorporate different power in different design. Like they just introduce you +3 diopter at 40 centimeter, and that +3 diopter will get elongated at particular distance, so you don't have to actually incorporate different power in different design. So that one line focus will give you a flexible range to read at different level also. So in short, I will just explain something in Hindi also. मैं आपको अगर सिंपल में बताऊं तो एक पॉइंट फोकस अगर आपको एक पर्टिकुलर एरिया में अगर रीड करने देता है, लाइक आपके जो मल्टीफोकल या फिर आपके प्रोग्रेसिव लेंसेज है, EDOF आपको वो पॉइंट को एक्सटेंड करके देगा जहां पर आपको डिफरेंट लेवल पे अलग अलग पावर की जरूरत नहीं रहती है. आई एम एक्चुअली गेटिंग मच मैसेज, लाइक यू कैन टॉक इन हिंदी फॉर अस टू गेट बेटर अंडरस्टैंड. So I hope I have explained you, Preeta. In order, if you need some more explanation, you can actually mail me. I will just share you my mail ID in the end of this slide.
Sure, I'll do that. The concept sounds amazing though. What I was thinking was, every patient's aberrations are different. So how a constant, aberration control is going to work on every individual?
So look, yes, you have said true. Every patient, ocular aberration are different. But what they have done, it's been more than 15 years they have worked on this design. Like Sir Brandon Roden have worked on this design. They have taken into consideration of aberration change while accommodation also. And when you're not, when your accommodation is at relax, the aberration control thing take place. So EDOF design actually incorporate that both aberration of your eye plus the aberration which will cause from the contact lenses, and give you a specific design which they have taken into consideration. So in a simple term, they have actually taken the average of that aberration which, in which you know the eye will take place. So EDOF, it's a particular lens which give you a different curve for different rays, thus taking into consideration of a higher order aberration, which will, you know, just compress your ocular aberration, give you a clearer image in your eye. So in simple term, मैं आपको normal में भी बताऊँ, तो आपके EDOF का जो higher order aberration जो हम control करके आपको जो एक line image देते हैं, वो कहीं ना कहीं आपके आई के एब्रेशन से मैच करके उसे सप्रेस करता है. सो आपके आई के जो एब्रेशन होगा वहां पर इसका इफेक्ट नहीं होगा.
थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू.
हेलो
हेलो
माई सेल्फ
सॉरी प्लीज 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 प्लीज
प्लीज कैन आई स्पीक.
या
आई एम डॉक्टर अनूप शाह स्पीकिंग.
हेलो डॉक्टर अनूप शाह.
Yeah, when you are talking about the high addition, meaning plus two and more than that, you showed one dominant eye, the other non-dominant eye, and it was mentioned that in the dominant eye, you use high addition.
Yes, yes, it was reversed than typical what we are prescribing here.
Yeah, like when we
concentrated on that thing. So it's not a mistake, it's actually a fitting guide of EDOF where you have to, you know, give a higher add value to your dominant eye. So as I told you, EDOF is neither center near or center distance thing. So EDOF technology is like that. The higher the addition, the higher the depth of focus. Okay, as I have, you know, mentioned in my earlier slide, as we go higher in addition, your depth of focus get increased.
Sorry.
So that is why it is, you know, given in a fitting guideline as you have to increase your depth of focus with your dominant eye. As your dominant eye work very well for your, yes?
But the distant vision decreases, that is what is mentioned, isn't it?
Yes, you know, in an EDOF, your distance vision anyhow get compromised a little bit because, you know, we are just extended that point focus to a particular line focus. But as we have seen in our study, that distance, you know, image will not get so much compromised that your patient will feel difference in a normal multifocal and EDOF. That is why.
The point is, if we give a higher addition in the non-dominant eye, where the distant vision is not as much required as compared to the dominant eye, that is what logic we use during operations. We use dominant eye for distance and non-dominant eye for near.
Yes. So you know, that if is you are seeing mention over here below, if you can read that thing, reverse the design on the eye if a patient is having trouble adaptation.
Okay. Okay.
So that is why if a patient is having trouble in adaptation with the higher eye in the dominant eye, you can actually reverse that thing. But as the fitting guideline is given from BHVI and C, they are saying that you can actually, you have to go with the dominant eye with the higher as to give you a better depth of perception for your near vision.
Okay.
But
okay.
If any case, you know, I have seen this for myself also. If any case you find your patient is not getting adapted with the higher ad value in your dominant eye, you can actually switch it back. So no hard and fast rule for.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Usman here.
Hi, Usman sir.
Excuse me, sir. Please. I'm in connection to Dr. Anoop.
Yes.
In connection to Dr. Anoop, my question is: if we are giving high ad in a dominant eye, do we need to modify a distance prescription?
So, sir, this all thing will go when you are giving a first trial lens to your patient. So like if when you have given the higher end in the middle end for the trial lens, you have to first check your distance vision before checking your near vision. If you find any difference in your distance vision, correct your distance vision first, then you have to check your near vision. So like when you are giving a higher end in your dominant eye and your patient distance visual demanding is less than your actual prescribed value, you can go less amount for your distance rather than shifting your addition power. So a fitting guideline is very easy. take a trial lens, fit on your patient eye. First, start with your distance correction, see how your distance correction is working, adjust your distance correction, and go with your near correction.
Okay.
Hello. I'm
okay.
Kundan Chu.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm Kundan Chu.
Yes,
yeah. Kundan Ji. This is about the mono vision, which I'm speaking in Hindi, so better I can explain you. जो मोनोविजन जो हम लोग चेक करते हैं इट इज सॉरी डोमिनेटिंग आई जो हम चेक करते हैं वो हम लोग मोनोविजन जब भी कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस देना होता है या लैसिक का सर्जरी होता है या आई होल फिट करते हैं उसमें ये जरूरत पड़ता है. अभी जब हम ये जब हम लोग रिफ्रेक्शन करते हैं तो इसमें तो फुल करेक्शन हो जाता है. मतलब रिफ्रेक्शन तो हम लोग फुल करेक्शन देते हैं ना. मोनोविजन में जब हम लेंस देते हैं तो उसमें हमको सिंगल विजन जो लेंस होता है वो मतलब दोनों पर्पस के लिए देना पड़ता है, रीडिंग के लिए और डिस्टेंस के लिए. तो उसमें हम लोग डोमिनेटिंग आई को ये करते हैं, मतलब उसको ये परफॉर्म करते हैं. तो जब हमारा रिफ्रेक्शन पूरा करेक्शन हो चुका है तो उसमें मोनोविजन की ये डोमिनेटिंग आई क्यों चेक करना पड़ता है?
सर देखिए, मैं आपको एक चीज बताता हूँ. जब हम मल्टीफोकल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस का वर्क करते हैं तो मल्टीफोकल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस में अभी आप इडॉफ को भूल जाइए. मैं आपको नॉर्मल जो कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस मार्केट में अवेलेबल है जैसे प्रोग्रेसिव या बायोफोकल टाइप का है. सो नॉर्मल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस में हम डोमिनेंट नॉन डोमिनेंट आई क्यों करते हैं? क्योंकि देखिए, डोमिनेंट आई आपका जो रहता है ना वो काफी पावरफुल रहता है या फिर बहुत सेंसिटिव रहता है आपके विजुअल डिमांड पे. सो हम डोमिनेंट आई में यूजुअली जितना चाहे लो एड दे सकते हैं या हमें लो एड देना चाहिए ताकि आपका डिस्टेंस विजन कॉम्प्रोमाइज ना हो. सो हम कोई भी अगर मल्टीफोकल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस फिट करते हैं तो डोमिनेंट आई में हम यूजुअली ट्राई करते हैं लो एड दे और नॉन डोमिनेंट आई में हम हाई एड देते हैं. क्योंकि कोई कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस अगर आप देते हो जिसमें एडिशन काफी ज्यादा है आपका डिस्टेंस विजन हैम्पर होता है, आपका डिस्टेंस विजन ड्रॉप होता है, प्लस आपको हेलोज या फिर कोई और इफेक्ट आ सकता है. जैसे आपके पेशेंट का भी जो स्पेक्टिकल प्रोग्रेसिव लेंसेज आते हैं अगर आप उनको हाई एडिशन दे देते हो या फिर बायफोकल में हायर एडिशन पावर देते हो तो वो कहते हैं चलने में तकलीफ होता है या फिर स्टेयरकेस उतरने या चढ़ने में तकलीफ होता है तो आपका डिस्टेंस विजन कहीं ना कहीं कॉम्प्रोमाइज होता है. सो जो नॉर्मल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेज है, मैं इडॉफ की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ, नॉर्मल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेज है उसमें डोमिनेंट नॉन डोमिनेंट इसलिए हम चेक करते हैं ताकि डोमिनेंट आई को हम डिस्टेंस के लिए ज्यादा पावरफुल बना पाए या फिर उनको डिस्टेंस में कोई एम्पर ना हो. बट जो आपका नॉन डोमिनेंट आई है, सॉरी डोमिनेंट आई को हम डिस्टेंस के लिए बना पाए और जो नॉन डोमिनेंट आई है उसको हम रीडिंग के लिए पावरफुल बना पाए ताकि आपका दोनों आई अच्छे से वर्क कर सके. सो जहां तक इडॉफ की बात आती है, देखिए इडॉफ आपका सेंटर नियर सेंटर डिस्टेंस या प्रोग्रेसिव मल्टीफोकल नहीं है. ये एक डिफरेंट टाइप का मल्टीफोकल है जहां पर आपका जो रे है वो इटसेल्फ बेंड होता है. लाइक आपके रे जो आपके आई में जाके बेंड होना चाहिए वो कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस पहले से ही उसको बेंड करके आई में भेजता है. ये लाइक एक एनक्रिप्टेड मैसेज है. नॉर्मल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस में से रे आपके आई में जाती है फिर वो एनक्रिप्ट होता है, वो पॉइंट फोकस फॉर्म होता है रेटिना पे. यहाँ ये जो इडॉफ है वो एक स्मार्ट लेंसेज है जो रे को पहले ही बेंड करता है और वो अपने मन चाहे वे से आपके रेटिना पे प्रोजेक्ट करता है. तो ये फिटिंग गाइडलाइन के हिसाब से आपका जो डोमिनेंट आई है जो इडॉफ के फिटिंग गाइडलाइन में है डोमिनेंट आई में आपको हाई एड देना चाहिए. बट एनी हाउ जैसे मैंने पहले भी बताया आप स्विच कर सकते हो, आप अपना नॉर्मल वे भी चला सकते हो, बट ये फिटिंग गाइडलाइन है हमारी इडॉफ की. सो इसे नॉर्मल मल्टीपल से कंपेयर मत कीजिए वो जो आपके जो नॉर्मल मार्केट में अवेलेबल है या फिर जो आप मोनोविजन में यूज करते हैं.
मोनोविजन में जब भी हम डिस्टेंस में हम लोग उसको ये देते हैं ना, मतलब लेस पावर देते हैं डिस्टेंस में उसको कॉम्प्रोमाइज करने को कहते हैं. मोनोविजन जब भी देते हैं नॉर्मल लेंस देते हैं तो उसको डोमिनेटिंग आई में उसको हम कहते हैं कि डिस्टेंस में आपको थोड़ा कम दिखाई देगा. मतलब अगर आप ये मोनोक्युलर विजन देखेंगे तो डिस्टेंस में आपको कम दिखाई देगा, ऐसा कस्टमर को अवेयर कराते हैं. मतलब
क्योंकि आपका जो डोमिनेंट है, देख डोमिनेंट आई में हम उनका विजन कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं करते हैं डिस्टेंस के लिए, बट जो नॉन डोमिनेंट आई रहता है उसमें हम उनका विजन कॉम्प्रोमाइज करते हैं जहाँ पर हम उनको थोड़ा कम या ज्यादा पावर देते हैं आपके रीडिंग देखने के लिए. देखिए वहां पर है ना आपका विजन कॉम्प्रोमाइज अलग वे से होता है, वहां आपका विजुअल एक्विटी बायनोक्युलरली ड्रॉप नहीं होता है क्योंकि आपके डोमिनेंट आई से आपका विजुअल एक्विटी काफी अच्छा रहेगा क्या, क्योंकि हमने वहां पर कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं किया है. वहां आपका बायनोक्युलर विजुअल एक्विटी में ड्रॉप आता है क्योंकि जब भी आप दोनों आई से देखोगे तो आपका दोनों ऐसे अलग अलग इमेज प्रोजेक्ट होगा आपके रेटिना पे, एक आई का इमेज काफी क्लियर रहेगा डिस्टेंस से, और एक आई का इमेज जिसमें आपने नियर मॉडिफाई किया है वो थोड़ा ब्लर रहेगा। ये दो इमेज जब आपके रेटिना में आपके ब्रेन में जाके कंबाइंड होता है ना, तो एक्चुअल राइट आई के गुड क्वालिटी इमेज से आपका यू नो कंबाइंड होके थोड़ा इमेज ड्रॉप होता है, तो वहां पर कहीं ना कहीं आपको लगता है कि आपका डिस्टेंस विजन जो है कॉम्प्रोमाइज होता है मोनोक्युलर कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस फिटिंग में या मोनोविजन।
दूसरा बात ये जो आप कहते हैं कि ये तो ना प्रोग्रेसिव है, नहीं बाइफोकल है, नहीं सेंटर डिस्टेंस या सेंटर नियर, अदरवाइज ये जो आप सेंटर जो जो पॉइंट लाइन बनाएंगे, फोकस लाइन बनाएंगे जो, तो वो उसको मेंटेन करने के लिए तो आपको लेंस का जो डिजाइन है उसमें प्रोग्रेशन लाना पड़ेगा ना, पावर का कुछ उसमें करेक्शन करना पड़ेगा, दिस इज एज वेल एज प्रोग्रेसिव हो गया ना आपको फोकस लाइन बनाने के लिए
और बीच में ना लाइन से एक एक पावर आता है जो आपके विजुअल इंटरमीडिएट डिमांड को नीड करता है। अगर मैं आपको इडॉफ की बात बताऊं तो आपका ये डिस्टेंस है, ये नियर है जो हम इलोंगेट कर देते हैं, और इंटरमीडिएट जोन में भी ना एक ही पावर रहता है, वो इलॉन्गेटेड रहता है, आपको डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पावर की जरूरत नहीं है इडॉफ में। जैसे अगर मैं आपको नॉर्मल एग्जांपल दूं, अगर मेरा रीडिंग डिस्टेंस अगर मैं 40 सेंटीमीटर पे होल्ड करता हूँ तो मुझे सपोज करिए 2.5 का नीड है, बट अगर मैं उसको 30 सेंटीमीटर पे होल्ड करता हूँ तो मुझे +3 डायपर का नीड है। सो ये आपका नॉर्मल मल्टीफोकल वर्किंग है, बट इडॉफ क्या करता है आपका अगर 40 सेंटीमीटर पे मेरा अगर प्लस यू नो 2.5 डायपर का अगर मेरा नीड है तो 2.5 डायपर की इमेज को वो इतना इलॉन्गेट कर देगा कि वो यू नो 40 से 35 सेंटीमीटर पे आने पे भी मेरा विजन क्लियर रहेगा, वो ब्लर नहीं होगा। आप ये कॉन्सेप्ट समझ रहे हो?
जी समझ गया। अच्छा,
यहाँ पर आपको डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पावर का रिक्वायरमेंट है, या आपका इडॉफ जो है आपका ना प्रोग्रेसिव नहीं, वो आपके इमेज को ऐसा इलॉन्गेट कर देता है जहाँ पर आपके अलग अलग पे भी इमेज क्लियर रहेगा।
और एक छोटा बात है, ये जो आपने रेशो बताया, हम लोग नॉर्मल लेंस में 4:1 का सिलेंडर का हम लोग ये कॉम्प्रोमाइज ये मतलब करेक्शन करते हैं, यहाँ पर आपने -3:1 किया है, तो उसका रीजन बताएंगे क्या है?
सर देखिए, ये 4:1 जो है ना वो आपका बहुत सेफ रेशो है जब आप यू नो एक स्फेरिकल इक्विवेलेंट पे जाते हो, बट मैंने अपने प्रैक्टिस में भी देखा हो या फिर काफी जगह देखा हो जहाँ आप 3:1 के साथ में भी बहुत अच्छे से वर्क कर पाते हो, बट 3:1 के आप नीचे आओगे तो कहीं ना कहीं आपका विजुअल डिमांड बहुत कॉम्प्रोमाइज होता है। तो मिनिमम रिक्वायरमेंट ये समझ लीजिए 3:1 है, लाइक -3 विथ 1 सिलिंड्रिकल के साथ आप जा सकते हो विथ 3.25-3.5 एडाप्टर में, बट आपका अगर 2:1 का रेशियो आता है तो आपका काफी हद तक का आपका विजुअल या फिर डिस्टेंस विजन हैम्पर हो जाएगा। तो ऐसे एक मिनिमम रखिए 3:1, देन बहुत सेफेस्ट के साइड में आपको जाना है तो 4:1, देन आप उससे जितना आगे जाओगे आपका विजुअल डिमांड अच्छा होता जाएगा।
ओके, थैंक यू हमजा।
हाय हमजा, दिस इज अनुराग।
जी अनुराग जी,
हां, हाउ इंपॉर्टेंट इज इट टू कंसीडर द प्यूपिलरी प्यूपिल साइज यू नो इन द फिटिंग ऑफ फीड ऑफ लेंसेज? As we know that while fitting the normal regular multifocal lenses, if it's a center near design, so we avoid you know going in bright light as it'll affect the distance visual acuity. And similarly, you know when we are using a center near, center distance design. So generally in scotopic conditions, when the pupil enlarges, the person can feel glare and halos. So, like in EDOF, is it the same, you know?
Sir, it's a way different in EDOF. You know, I have just projected one slide on your screen. You can see, if we consider a bifocal or in progressive lenses, it is very sensitive with your pupil size. Because, you know, if you are taking into consideration of center near bifocal or center near progressive lenses, if your pupil is very scotopic, like, you know, it's around 2 mm, let's say it's very very much scotopic in nature, so your more of your visual demand or more of your vision will go from your near vision area in your contact lenses. So thus patient will you know feel your vision is blur when they are going in a daylight condition, that is why, you know, in multifocal contact lenses, special the ECP or your the practitioner usually recommend you not to drive with your contact lenses. Am I right?
Yeah, true. Or else we tell the patient to use a goggles over their multifocal lenses.
Yeah. Because, you know, if it's in a daylight condition, people get constricted, most of your vision area will go from your near vision part of your contact lenses. What EDOF they have done, as you can see the lower part, you can see the design of EDOF where your people even getting constricted to 3mm also or 2.5mm also, all the area like your distance near and intermediate fall in that zone only.
Sorry.
This part, lower part.
Hello, Hamza.
And if you are saying that even if in smaller pupils, the distance and the near lies in the same pupillary area, won't it produce more of halos in dim light condition?
No, sir. It's like working hand in hand. When your pupil get increased, the adapted contact lens area will give you a focus in that line image. So let's see, if your pupil area get increased, na, your line image will form even far better than your constricted pupil area. So not consider these lenses as your typical progressive lens where your pupil area decide which area is getting eliminated or not. Here your line focus will get, you know, cut off in half if it's getting constricted pupil, or it will just extend when your pupil is getting dilated. It's simple concept.
So pupillary size doesn't matter so much in the fitting of EDOF lenses.
Doesn't matter so much. I'm not saying that it will not at all matter. It will matter if your pupil is getting, you know, constricted.
Not as much as we do it in multifocal lenses.
So it's simple. If it's a point focus, if it's get blocked, it's got block as all. But if it's a line focus, it will not get blocked so much. It will give you a small amount of vision then also.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Hello, Hamza. Sanjay here.
Ji, Sanjay ji.
Yeah. See, I have a patient of mine who is using multifocal lenses. He's using only when he's using his VR. Okay, game. When he was playing VR games. So what you suggest? Okay. This will be an ideal candidate because the pupil constriction, considering everything, what do you feel?
When we are talking about the VR, as I am getting you the VR, that actual virtual reality device when you are using, yes. So, you know, in VR, we are getting more exposure to the concentration of light. So obviously it will, you know, it has to perform better than the other multifocal lenses, considering your pupil get constricted because you are very close to your screen. But, you know, somehow this lenses is designed to work with your, actual working environment, like, you know, seeing for distance and seeing for near. As far as your VR is concerned, your VR work at very close to your eye. It will be around, you know, let's say it's around 20 centimeter or lesser than that.
Yeah.
So we have to see whether this lenses will work, but obviously I can say you that it will work far better than the actual or the recently available multifocal lenses design. It can work better than that, but again we have to see whether it's working. Actually, you can tell us, like, if your patient is using EDOF, you can order a trial from us and you can let us know whether VR is more comfortable with EDOF or not.
Hello.
Hello,
Amja.
Hello.
Ajay, yeah? You are in the patient selection. In that section, you are told that the person having 2.5 mm this pupil that diameter, mesopic condition. So can you elaborate on this particular subject? Patient selection.
This is only, no? Like the pupil size less than 2.5 mm in mesopic condition.
Yeah. So can you elaborate on this particular?
In some time, patient usually have a mesopic pupil, which is not a sensory function. You know, some patient usually by nature has a very less dire pupil, where patient, you know, see a less amount of ray getting entered to your retina. So when you are moving to a harsh light and when a patient pupil is mesopic, like, you know, it's lesser than the normal pupil size, your pupil will get even more constricted in your daylight area. So, you know, we have seen a EDOF lenses working very well with a normal pupil size, which is around 4 to 6 mm of diameter. But they have seen that if you go below to 2.5 mm diameter, somehow we will not get that range of line of focus where, which we need actually to see near or distance vision clearly. So let us consider as the threshold point of that line. Like if you are, you know, getting below 2.5, that whole line will get blocked anyway. So okay. That threshold will be like, you know, it has to be greater than 2.5 mm of that. And 2.5 is very small. It's okay. Like, you know, the normal market pinhole, which is around 2 mm.
Okay, we'll get one trial lens for him and then we'll see. Okay,
so actually,
thank you.
Order trial lenses if you want. I will mention you my email ID at the end of this slide.
Sure.
And if you want a trial from this, you can actually order a trial from us.
Thanks.
Should I proceed ahead, because then it's actually a time we are lacking off.
Thank you, Abhya.
Thank you so much. So we will move ahead with the you know, new concept of EDOF, which is a myopia control thing. Look, EDOF is actually a design which was designed from, which was, you know, designed from Brandon Holden sir actually to work for a myopia control. But somehow myopia control get involved with the presbyopic thing, and right now we have a contact lenses which work, or which is like a next generation contact lenses for your presbyopia, and also this lens work for your myopia control also. So before we start with all this thing, we have anyone who is working as a myopia control in this webinar, who are working with myopia control, or who have done a myopia control thing either with a specialty contact lenses or you know, soft contact lenses?
Hamza, I've been doing orthokeratology and have few patients for myopia
control, which is orthokeratology. So Anurag Vaishji is doing a myopia control. Any other, anyone else? Okay, seems to be we have very few, or you know, the reason kind which I find, like, you know, people or the practitioner or the optometrists are not going behind a myopia control thing as of now. It's booming right now, but as of now they are not doing this thing because, you know, many of the concept of myopia control are still not so clear. We don't know how to actually control myopia, at what age we have to control myopia. So it's a total different topic. So let me know if you want you know, different presentation for myopia control with other, like orthokeratology or EDOF or some other technique if you want. There are also a spectacle lenses, specially designed spectacle lenses for your myopia control. I hope you all know, or if you don't know. So there are lenses from a optical company or spectacle lens manufacturing company which can actually control your myopia. So myopia control usually start between the age of let's say 4+ or 5+ of age, and then it goes till your adolescence or till, you know, 18 to 20 years. So we have to start myopia control as early as possible when you find a patient who is suffering from a progressive myopia. Okay, so let's start with the potential of myopia control management with seed one day pure EDOF. Okay, so as we all know, myopia control can be done with various options. The first of all, which is, you know, very normal thing, which is a spectacle control way of myopia controlling, which give you, there are different types of spectacle which can actually control a myopia, whether it will be executive bifocal, the peripheral aspheric progressive addition lenses, a peripheral defocus thing. This peripheral defocus spectacle lens is available with a company named Hoya, which is again a Japanese company. They have these lenses which will give you a peripheral defocus for your myopia control thing, or a defocus incorporated in multiple segment. So you have to actually you know, design a lenses which will give you a peripheral blur vision. In defocus thing, we need this thing, a peripheral blur vision for your myopia defocus thing. So, अगर मैं नॉर्मल वे में आपको बताऊँ, सो मायोपिया कंट्रोल के लिए हमें ऐसा डिवाइस चाहिए रहता है जहाँ पर हमारा सेंट्रल विजन क्लियर होना चाहिए, बट पेरीफेरी वाला विजन थोड़ा ब्लर होना चाहिए. वो हमारे रेटिना से कंसर्न होता है. एक और जो मेथड है वो है आप हमारा कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेस का. कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेस में दो वे से स्टार्ट होता है. फर्स्ट इज ऑर्थोकेराटोलॉजी. सो ऑर्थोकेराटोलॉजी इज अ वेरी यू नो बूमिंग राइट नाउ फ्रॉम आई कैन से फ्रॉम लास्ट 2 to 3 years. दे आर एक्चुअली इन अ वेरी मच बूम. पीपल आर very much curious about you know starting with orthokeratology. Many companies are come up with orthoke lenses. Even Seed also have orthoke lenses, which is known as a Breedo Correct. So many other lenses nowadays you get the fitting profile of contact lenses at various different company, the different types of lenses available for your toric, for your PAL edition lenses also. And another way of myopia control is your atropine. So the atropine or the penalization is also a way of controlling myopia. Sometimes people combine 2 to 3 techniques to control your myopia in a greater way. So let me tell you, if you are combining orthokeratology with atropine, the myopia controlling rate is about 90%. So there are different way right now people are doing myopia control in their own strategic levels. So right now we will be talking about the extended depth of focus or EDOF lenses for your myopia control thing. So some basic for this thing: at birth, optics of the eye is ill matched. We all know we are high hyprope when we are born, and our axial lens is not so much developed, so our vision get clear. Postnatal period, homeostatic growth control mechanism ensure emetropia. So जैसे जैसे हम बड़े होते हैं, हमारा आय धीरे धीरे ग्रो होता है और हमारा जो स्टेट है वो ईमेट्रोपिया की तरफ शिफ्ट होता है. फेलियर ऑफ ईमेट्रोपाइजेशन प्रोसेस रिजल्ट इन रिफ्रेक्टिव एरिया. अगर कोई भी ये प्रोसेस में अगर कोई इश्यूज आता है, लाइक आपका विजुअल विजुअल पाथवे क्लियर नहीं है, या आपका विजन क्लियर नहीं है, या आपका विजन आपके आई बॉल में कुछ और है जो एब्स्ट्रक्ट कर रहा है आपके विजन में, तो कहीं ना कहीं आपको ये रिफ्रेक्टिव एरिया आने के चांसेस रहते हैं. ऑब्वियसली the genetics also matter in this thing. So lens compensation study shows eye growth is visually guided. So आपका जो eye growth है वो visually guided रहता है. Like अगर मैं आपको बताऊँ, आपका eye जो बचपन में है वो काफी small रहता है axial length में, और आपका जो eye focus होता है या आपका जो vision focus होता है वो काफी पीछे की side में focus होता है, जैसे हमारे hyprope में है. So अगर retina के पीछे image focus हो रहा है तो धीरे धीरे आपके आईबॉल को ये सेंसेस जाएगा कि हमारा जो रेटिना या हमारा आईबॉल है उससे थोड़ा ग्रो होना है, ताकि पीछे जो पॉइंट फोकस बन रहा है वो रेटिना पे बने. तो कहीं ना कहीं हमारा जो आईबॉल का ग्रोथ है वो विजुअली गाइडेड रहता है, लाइक आपका विजन गाइड करता है उसको किस साइड पे ग्रो होना चाहिए. सो सॉफ्ट कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस ऑप्टिकल ट्रीटमेंट स्ट्रेटेजीज आर डुअल फोकस और मल्टी फोकल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस. सो जो सॉफ्ट कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेज में जो दो टाइप के हम मायोपिया कंट्रोल स्टडीज या फिर मायोपिया कंट्रोल मेथड देखते हैं, वो एक तो है डुअल फोकस या फिर मल्टीफोकल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेज, जो आपका सेंटर डिस्टेंस होना चाहिए. लाइक सेंटर डिस्टेंस लेंसेज विल वर्क फॉर योर मायोपिया कंट्रोल आल्सो, एंड अ सेंटर डिस्टेंस लाइक मल्टीफोकल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेज फॉर पेरिफेरल मायोपिया डिफोकसिंग थिंग. सो this is a very clear and good image for you to study about how a defocused image will guide your eye to not grow beyond the normal limit of emetropia. As we all know, the emetropia is when the ray of light coming from infinity or an object form a point focus on your retina. So this is your emetropic eye where you have no error. The myopia will form when the image is in front of retina, and hyperopia will form when the image is behind the retina. So what we are doing in myopia control is actually creating a myopic defocus thing. As you can see a red curve over here, we have to form an image on retina. You can see a point over here, we can form an image on retina. It has to be very clear, but the image on the periphery has to be blurred and its point focus has to form in front of the retina. हमें एक ऐसा लेंस चाहिए जहां पर हमारा जो पॉइंट फोकस है वो रेटिना पे बने, बट उसके बाहर वाला या कि उसके पेरिफेरी वाला जो इमेज है वो रेटिना से पहले बनना चाहिए, ताकि रेटिना को ये सिग्नल नहीं जाए कि आई को और पीछे की साइड पे या और एक्सियल लेंस को बढ़ना है ताकि आपका इमेज क्लियर हो जाए. तो ये एक बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट है आपका मायोपिया कंट्रोल, वेदर वी आर कंट्रोलिंग इट फ्रॉम ऑप्टिक लेवल थिंग्स. सो ऑर्थोकेराटोलॉजिक प्रोसेस है जहाँ पर आपका मायोपिक डिफोकस आता है एक सेमी पेरिफेरल रिंग में, जहाँ पर आपका रेटिना से पहले एक इमेज फॉर्म होता है. एंड अनदर वे इज योर मल्टीफोकल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेज विच इज सेंटर डिस्टेंस मल्टीफोकल कॉन्टेक्ट लेंस वेयर पेरिफेरी विल बी योर प्लस पावर विच विल क्रिएट अ मायोपिक डिफोकस थिंग. अनदर वन इज योर EDOF. सो सम क्लिनिकल स्टडीज फॉर मायोपिक कंट्रोल फॉर EDOFs आर वी हैव डन टू वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टडी for myopia control thing for EDOF. One is for the visual clarity and visual acceptability. Another one is a 2-year efficacy study, and another one is a 6-month comparative study for myopia control. So what we have done over here, we have taken a 35 non-priced biopic enrollment participant between the age of 18 to 35, and we have taken into consideration three lenses, which is EDOF one type, EDOF two type. There are two types of design which is internal to our company. Another third lenses is Proclear multifocal, which is center distance. They are using Proclear multifocal for myopia control. And another lenses is from Cooper Vision, which is MySight. It's a it's a very fascinating lenses developed from Cooper, which they are saying it's control myopia. So we have tested all of these lenses and we will see how these lenses is working. So first of all, the subjective vision, the visual clarity, how overall clarity is, overall lack of ghosting is. So as you can see, the yellow and orange line will indicate the EDOF lenses up to quality, and the green indicate the Proclear multifocal, and blue indicate the MySight. So overall, you can see EDOF is performing very well as far as the visual clarity is concerned, but it's for the myopia control type of view. So lack of halos, overall vision satisfaction or ocular comfort can be seen very well in EDOF. So another efficacy study, which was of 2-year study. So now it's, we have taken 523 participants, which is from 7 to 13 years of age. It's actually a very crucial age for your myopia control thing. You can see different types of lenses where different design, which will give you a power distribution. It's a randomized study, double marks parallel arm, which give you a 2-year follow-up about the visual correction for EDOF and other lenses. So what we have seen is like when you are wearing a single vision lenses, you can see over here, a patient who is wearing a single vision lenses, the axial length progress very high when you compare it with the EDOF lenses. So if you're giving EDOF lenses to a to a child or your patient who is on a myopia progression thing, you will see their axial length is growing lesser than the actual axial length will grow from your single vision lenses. Also, the spherical equivalent or the progression of spherical power will get reduced when you're wearing EDOF lenses. So EDOF lens significantly slow myopia progression. As you can see over here, overall comfort and all thing does not really change when you are comparing it with the single vision. Look, EDOF will give you a slightly, very slightly lower image quality when you compare it with your single vision as far as your myopia control is concerned. But here we are, more of the concern for myopia progression where we have to do a myopia control thing. So some of the discontinued thing where these people have discontinued, where major of them were discontinued from discomfort. Obviously, when you will comparing it with your single vision lenses, the patient will find some visual discomfort in EDOF as your peripheral vision will get blur, and other was symptoms problem, the job conflicts, unacceptable vision and other things. So EDOF shows a significant myopia control efficacy compared to single vision control. Myopia control efficacy is not only significantly different between the two of EDOF design. We have two design, we have checked it otherwise, which was showing the consideration value. Visual acuity reduction with EDOF lenses is less than one line. So when you're comparing it, when you're comparing EDOF with the single vision lenses, it's the visual acuity will be visual acuity reduction will be less than one line. So if you are seeing a patient with a single vision lenses which is 6-6, you can find your EDOF lenses will give you a 6-6 part or 6-9 plus of vision. So subjective vision not different between EDOF and single vision contact lenses. So another a very interesting study which was performed with BHVI, which is Brandon Holder Vision Institute. They have taken three groups. First group was given a single vision correction. Second group was given one eye single vision and another eye my side, which is a myopia control lenses from Cooper. And the third group was given one eye single vision and one eye EDOF lenses to see whether all of these lenses, whether you know my side is performing well or EDOF is performing well, or these two performing well with your single vision lenses. So you can see a graph over here. We have, you know, spent a 6 month time with this patient with a continuous follow-up of this thing of their power and the actual lenses. So you can see a red line which indicate the upper line indicate the actual line, and the lower line indicate the spherical equivalent changes, the power and your actual length. You can see a patient who is wearing a single vision lenses, their actual length and their power grow drastically. But in a my side, their actual length and their power does not grow so much. It gets reduced 40 to 50% in between ranges. Also, you can see in a EDOF lenses, it get reduced 63 to 40%. So if you are not going with the single vision lenses, you have to actually go with the any of the myopia control thing where you can see a reduction in your actual length and your power. So another, after 6 months, what we have done, we have just switched our single vision lenses with myopia control lenses. Like the patient who is wearing one eye single vision lenses, we have given that eye my side, and another eye which they are using my side, they have given that eye a single vision lenses. So we have just switched it over. As you can see over here, the lenses which was a single vision lens which is wearing eye, it shows a reduction in the actual length as well as reduction in the power over a span of 6 months more. So this is a 12 month study. And the eye which was using the myopia control lenses, when we have shifted it to a single vision lenses, they show a significant growth overall, where they have to show us a downfall curve in this thing. Same goes with the EDOF. When we switch single vision lenses to EDOF, you can see there was a significant difference of 60+ percentage in their axial length and their spherical equivalent changes. So anyhow, EDOF lenses or any myopia control lenses will work better for your myopia control thing when you are comparing it with your single vision lenses. So right now people are more concerned about giving a myopia control contact lenses or center distance multifocal contact lenses to your patient who are 4+ or 5+ of age, if you are finding them to be a myopia control patient. So you can actually start with this myopia control study. So summary of EDOF as myopia management: confirmed potential as solution for myopia control, demonstrated myopia control efficacy, provide better vision versus multifocal contact lenses for young myopes. Overall summary, again, EDOF lens technology is designed based on higher order aberration. The high depth of focus type offer wider range of vision, while low depth of focus perceive better retinal image quality. Evidence of EDOF on EDOF against myopia progression demonstrated and confirmed. So this is the range of power and base curve which someone has asked me. So you can see over here, EDOF is right now available with 1 day disposable segment with seed. We have our office in Mulund, so you can order your trial lenses. So right now, I think we have a trial lens from +4 to 5 diopter till -6. Order us. I will let you know my mail ID. You can order us your lenses. Just let us know your spectacle power. Do not give us your actual wearing multifocal contact lenses. Just give us your patient spectacle power, and we will convert it and let you know what power is good enough for your first trial of fitting. So it is available with 1 day disposable. It's a 32 lens pack. We will let you know about the price of these lenses, and it's available in 8.4 base curve with a diopter of 14.2. It's a type of hydrogel material, but we have incorporated seed in-house material with it, which will give you a higher dk by t value, which is 42.9, and giving you a flux rate of 90%, more than 90% of your flux rate, which is more than enough. Like it is 40 times more than enough than your actual daytime wearing contact lenses. So I have mentioned my mail ID. I have mentioned my contact number. So if you have any of your trial order, let me know by mail or my contact number on WhatsApp. And if you have any query, you can actually mail me and ask me if you want anything. So if you have any question, you can ask, or we will end this presentation today.